Hello and welcome back to XCOM 2, War of the Chosen. This is the Legendary Ironman Army of 2 run, where we are trying to beat the entire game with only 2 soldiers per mission. It's time for a secure transmission mission from the Templars, the Lightning Observer, Operation Lone Knife, actually. It is going to be one of the more difficult missions with a lot of Horde. Gosh, I am unconcentrated today. That's going to be fun. So we have a lot of Horde swarming the area, which means one of our troopers should have a sidearm that does not require ammunition, aka we should either bring a sniper or a Templar. Our Templar is currently in the med bay, so it's going to be Edgar Allan Poe on this mission. Good old Edgar Allan Poe today is going to be joined by Marino Cyber. Just so if you look at the roster, we could have brought Syken. He's already a colonel, and he would probably bring a lot to the mission, but I feel that Edgar Allan Poe, with his abilities, will be more than able to deal with the Chosen Ones, the Loss again, not the Chosen Ones. And Marino Cyber is brought in more for some security and some healing. We got ourselves the blue screen rounds equipped and some nice weaponry, so the two of them are hopefully going to pull it off. Love it.
Skyranger to squad green to deploy.
All right. Yet another interesting mission. Usually the missions that are direct communications with the Lost Ones are a bit easier, specifically if you have Between the Eyes, which allows you to kill the Chosen, the Lost Ones, with a single shot. And that's really what I'm banking on, to kill a lot of Lost with a single shot. Another interesting fun fact for extractions. I'm not sure if we do have stabilization on Marino. Oh gosh, that lagged a bit. If we do have stabilization on Marino, but the person that we actually need to rescue is unconscious, so having stabilization, which, yep, we do, will allow us to secure her from afar. We just need to stand up here, basically stabilize her, and that's it. The whole place is overrun and lost. Don't bother trying to outgun them. After you secure the expedition, you'll have to return to our original entry point for extraction. Don't get overrun. Keep the path back to Firebrand clear. Okay, fair enough. We know what's up. What I want to do is move in as fast as possible. Of course, we're triggering some loss, and that's okay. Edgar Allan Poe moves up, should see all three of the loss. And what we're going to do is we're simply going to block their option to get up the ladder with him positioning himself there. Good enough for now. Alright, let's take a look at Edgar. Nice little 100% shot here. Again, we have Between the Eyes, so really there is No chance for them to survive. Gosh, yet another couple of beautiful losses. Unfortunately, we can't get all the way up there. Moving up here and blocking their way would be perfect. Can't do that, so they will get up here and we need to somewhat hurry and get all the way over there.
Heading out.
Okay, we continue to double move. They can't reach us in one turn. I think we're going to be fine for now. Still overwatching in case someone manages to get upstairs. Alright, there we go. They start coming just a bit closer. Edgar here will clean up. It's one down. Two down. Three down. Four down. We just need to make sure that they are not getting close to us.
X-ray neutralized.
And so far we're doing a pretty decent job with that. So there's one and one entrance only, unless there is another couple of lost on the other side. Should be just fine standing there. Good. There is no one on the other side, which means that Galen Poe can block the way upwards, which means they can't reach us. They will now start to climb up this ladder here, which is okay.
You're almost out of ammo for the turret, Commander. We have to get moving.
I love it how Bradford begins to create panic.
I'm on the move.
Okay, moving on. I think next turn will be perfect. We're going to be just fine. Overwatch, overwatch.
The turret just ran dry of ammo. They've got nothing to hold back the loss now. Menace 1-5, get to their position on the double. On your order.
All right, so let's see if we can stabilize the soldier from here. A loss with 10 hit points. I am so grateful that we actually have Between the Eyes. A little bit of a lightning hands shot. Which missed. That is unfortunate. Just want to make sure he can't reach us. I think he can't.
Target neutralized.
There we go. Can't stabilize the guy yet, so might as well move up to here and overwatch. Right, there's the lost swarm. We play our cards right, we can eliminate every single one of them without even reloading. Edgar Allan Poe will have such a great experience gain in this mission. I already love it.
Target eliminated.
He gets some extra extra ability points from high ground shots. Another point, great.
Hostile terminated.
So not only does he get a lot of experience points, he also gets points for using high ground. That's perfect.
Hostile terminated.
Yeah, now it's 95%. That's bit more difficult.
Target neutralized.
100% to take the rifle, so let's just use that.
X-ray neutralized. Hostile terminated.
All right, he killed everyone.
Heading to that location.
This here will most likely trigger another set of lost.
VIP is secure, Commander. If we can spare the manpower, we should try to bring the escort in as well. Without the VIP manning the turret control, there's nothing keeping the Lost from overrunning this area. They're already closing in.
Yeah, so we need to be a bit careful here. But with the revival protocol, we should be fine, because now we don't need to carry anyone. Instead, we got a third soldier for now. Sir James is no longer unconscious, and that is good. Let's see if we can kill some of them. Apparently the answer is yes. Gosh, she's cleaning house. Oh, so she does not get the operative. She just deals normal damage. She doesn't automatically kill them. Well, I can certainly say there are a lot of losses here. That's, by the way, a perfect mission to get the sniper to colonel rank. We're not going to do that. I'm just mentioning it would be a perfect mission because, gosh, they are respawning and respawning and respawning.
Firebrand is in position. Get back to the entry point for extraction before you get overrun. We're picking up more heat signatures than the sensors can keep up with.
I quite frankly don't know if we were to get overrun. To be really honest.
Position confirmed.
All right, so we're going to move over here. Sarah could, what are the entry points? Sarah could block this one here. Yeah, let's do that. All right, Sarah's blocking this entry point.
Got it covered. On Overwatch.
Yeah, and we're easily overwatching and slowly moving back. They're trying to get up here, but they are failing to do so at the moment, or they're looking for other opportunities. Edgar's going to take a couple of shots. Let's make sure that we're killing as many as we can.
Hostile terminated.
Okay, so this gives us a pretty clear picture where everyone is. Moving over, blocking the entrance. And I think we should have one over here as well. And last but not least, let's continue to move. So they will move onto the middle ramp. That's okay, that's all good. We can continue to move over here onto this balcony and just kill most of them. Lost alone plus high ground with limited access, it's usually GG. They can't win that.
That one hurt a little.
Oh, wow. Someone even reached us. I'm mildly shocked about how far they can run. The civilian gets into cover.
I'm all over it.
So does she.
Target
Cyber moves over. Edgar Alien Poe takes the position which will block any entrance. And from here we're going to clean up. Alright, Edgar starts the purge. That's actually an amusingly easy mission. I like it. Thanks to between the eyes, this here is not dangerous at all. A lot of easy kills. And to be honest, I would expect that Edgar gets a promotion afterwards. Okay, how about we're starting to move all the way up here? Confirmed. Lots and lots and lots of new loss are coming. They are desperately trying to get up and fail. Instead, they are positioning themselves even easier.
Menace 1-5, keep pushing towards the evac point. No matter what you do, you're never gonna make a dent in the Lost. There's just too many coming in.
Yeah, that's all good, and we're not going to kill all of them, but we're killing a hell lot of them. Because that means experience for Edgar Alien Poe. He's the hero of this mission, so might as well have his 15 minutes of fame now. X-ray neutralized. Hostile target down. Target eliminated. Alright, I think we almost got everyone. New loss that just spawned are a bit far away. Alien Poe has a good aim, but not a perfect one so far. Well, he still hits every single shot, so doesn't really matter. Yeah, he quite literally has hit every single shot.
Got it.
Closing the back entrance. Moving our VIP over there. Starting to move the soldier over there. And let's reload. Edgar, in the meantime, just takes an overwatch. Yeah, the game throws another pair of loss at us every single turn. And that's really how you could power level here. The idea of the game is you are supposed to leave the mission, and by just standing there, you effectively defy the odds, and you could now cheese your way to the corporal rank by continuing to farm. Takes about, I would say, 300-ish kills, and then you should be there. Maybe a little bit more. Give and take. I don't know if they really count for one kill, or if they count for half a kill. I know it is possible, unless they bug fix it to really power level your soldier to the maximum level. And since there's always like a new wave coming in, what the game is trying to do with you is make you run, and what you do in reality is use all of the loss just to get more experience. We're still moving, by the way, as you can appreciate. Ready to engage. Overwatch. On my way. One out. Sends out. Next turn, Edgar Alien begins to move as well. We already start to get two of the operatives out. The swarm appears. The VIP safely on board the Sky Ranger.
Hostile target down. Understood. Moving out.
All right, everyone's out with the exception of Edgar, Alien Paul. We'll get her patched up and ready to redeploy into the field. Probably should have left her here because Edgar might get hit once from the sky downstairs. That was a slight mistake. Yeah, he's probably going to get hit once, which equals about 3 or 4 days in the med bay. Well, maybe more than that.
Hostile terminated.
Yeah, except the miss move, the last one that I did, where I should have left her there. The rest of the mission actually was quite smooth. So you can't complain too much.
All XCOM operatives are secure. Firebrand is returning to base.
64 kills. Good enough, I would say. Probably one promotion.
And despite the destruction left in their wake, XCOM refuses to let go of the ways of the old world. They will continue their wanton and reckless crimes until the entire world burns around them. We are grateful to the elders.
All right, so let's take a look. I think we might even got two promotions, so one each.
We're taking Advent apart one mission at a time.
Well, Cyber did not get a promotion, but for 90 kills, Edgar Alien Poe deserved his quick draw ability. Good job, buddy.
We are stronger by far.
We got an engineer, we got intel, we got a specialist. Really, really good. Okay, so we could try to continue excavating even more. Well, it's an option. I suppose with our limited energy, we need to get the exposed power coil done next, but that takes three engineers. So for now, let's get Let's get some vital updates here. And we got ourselves data here. Lieutenant data. I like it. She's yet another specialist, and I very much like specialists.
Your old man would be proud of what we've managed to do here. What you've managed to do with this ship.
I just wish he had lived long enough to see us fight back. To know that it wasn't all for nothing.
Trust me, he knows. If there was one thing your father always kept in mind...
Good. So Edgar Allan Poe... He knew we could win. ...has a couple of training points that we could invest. Let's just take a short look what his training could look like. He got Salvo, which is not particularly... No, we don't want to buy that. Salvo, which is not particularly great, but we could give him a couple of other abilities that are actually better. Run and gun, yes, certainly. Probably untouchable is pretty good. I like Shredder, just as a rider effect. Implacable, definitely good. Chain Shot isn't so good. It's not as good as you might think. Also, Rupture is not as good as you might think. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, for now, it's okay. Blast Padding is also okay. A bit more survivability, but yeah. He has 4 abilities. I will make up my mind as we go. I'm not yet convinced. Plus, I don't want to sink too many points into him. We need all of our points, probably for Roby and Magister, because so far they are my preferred combination for the more difficult missions. Nice, we got some more alien alloys. Well, the others disappeared. Oh no, it's probably the same. Anyways, 3 more days until the month is done and we're going to get some new supplies.
Coming through, Commander. Putting it on screen now.
Leading the resistance is a daunting task, Commander. But your efforts so far have left many wondering if we have made the right approach.
Is he really giving me a bad review? For 1 avatar progress with all of that here completed? Oh my gosh. This here is actually bad. She's going to hunt us down soon. That's okay. That's not so good. This is okay. This year we should probably get alloy paddings and try to counter it. I don't know what the hidden event is. This year is actually really, really bad, and this is also really, really bad. Look at it. Imminent new facility construction, which is a nice way of saying it's going to be even more difficult to stop the project, and pretty imminent retaliation strike. So with all that being said, we're still keeping the same old here. Couple of hours and then we are done with the supply run. We're soon going to see a retaliation mission and another facility, so expect to have 1 more avatar project, maybe even 2. And we yet can't get a single facility. The only one that we could get is the backside facility, which is probably something that we want to take for now. It's going to be a very difficult mission, though. Yeah, so that's the only thing that we could do so far. Maybe we get a facility lead somewhere.
There were some casualties during that last covert action.
Shit. The low chance of getting wounded has materialized, so Roby has received his promotion, but unfortunately got injured. So plus one damage for the pistols. This is actually a really, really good reward, and mobility isn't bad either. The worst part is I can already see we're not going to have any option to reduce the avatar progress. Hacking, resistance contacts plus one is good. We might want to consider that for expanding further into Europe. Plus hacking isn't bad either, so resistance contacts and pistol improvements, both good. The warlock is always good. This isn't bad either. Yeah. This here is really good. Mobility is also good. 8 days might be something we consider. Here is a promotion and an engineer. That's the best I've seen so far. We need engineers, we need promotions, so it's quite straightforward. Yeah. You know, knowing that we are... Let's look at our availability, okay? We got Roby, but we haven't gotten Magister yet. I want to use them together as a team. Full stop. Edgar Allan Poe, slightly wounded. That sucks. Big times. So... we might want to use the 7 days in order to use Roby here, because that's anyways what we wanted to do. Which will leave us wide open if we're being attacked with the retaliation mission, and I would need to come up with an idea of how to do that, because currently we're not ready. But yeah, I think that's the best way for now. So plan is, let's get the resistance contact with hacking 1 week. Take the breakthrough research. I like that a lot. But mobility is something that, not Roby, but, excuse me. Mobility is something that our melee character, so Magister, needs. So then we still have the promotion thing going, and for the promotion I would actually like to use Renvin, which we can do next. So let's, I'm sorry, I'm a little bit ill. Let's do the promotion second. What are we going to do first? I think we're going to go for the resistance contacts, because then we can also make contact to another country. Sergeant Plus, easy enough. We're just using cyber here. Ambush high. We're not using cyber here. Soldier wounded high. Okay. Are we really wanting to do that? Whom are we putting there together with Roby? I need Zirkim for the actual mission now. So it's probably really only cyber. Well, it is what it is. Roby gets some extra XP. Let's make the items available. You know what? We're going to keep blue screen rounds for others. And... how much How much supplies do we have? We need to build something for them. If they're actually going onto a mission, let's build something for them. Medkit, the second one, is good. And I think we're taking a second flashbang grenade. That's not bad either. Okay. So, gosh, covert missions can be complicated. Let's get Roby in here. There we go. Let's put Cyber with him.
Material we've seen them using all over the colonies, but they'd have to be producing it from something here on Earth. They seem to have an endless supply of this stuff.
Let's edit Roby as well. Medkit, flashbang grenade. Sounds good. And we don't have, oh gosh. No, that's not possible. We can't have a chance of letting them get captured. So we need to shortly visit the black market to get some. To get some supplies. I want to lose as little time as possible. Two mutant corpses sounds like a great idea to sell. Couple stun lancers, good enough. The reason why I don't want to lose any time is we need to really train our two soldiers as much as humanly possible. Okay, I still have their equipment. Now there is a high chance for an ambush and a high chance for someone getting wounded. It is what it is, but we get hacking out of it and a resistance contact. Good enough for me. Let's go, baby.
Understood, Commander. My followers will appreciate the support of your soldiers.
Renvin still got a promotion. I like it. Nice little untouchable. Good job. And soon he's going to be back. Since the attack is imminent, let's heal just a little bit faster because I have the hopes that we can get Renvin back and do the retaliation mission with Renvin and Syken.
Commander, the aliens aren't slowing down. They've already got multiple.
There is the next facility. Great. We're now at 5 facilities, I suppose. And we're almost at the point where I need to stop the Doom timer. Renvin is back. We have just healed him. Let's get Alien Alloys next and get ready for a terror attack, a retaliation strike. That's helpful. Every grenade had been upgraded to a plasma grenade. Okay. So, I'm thinking. We do have good ammunition. We might want to go for a grenade because we're low on supplies. So, let's take one grenade. And take out the engineer. Can already start with the excavation here. Just a couple of days down. We're going to shift them over once this is being cleared out. Yeah, we're a bit short on on supplies now. And that's what I was predicting. Nice little Haven assault. All right, good. That's going to happen in the next mission, guys. I think we have done all of the preparation that was possible from our side. Thank you so much for watching. And if you liked it, leave a comment down below. And you might consider wanting to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thank you. Have a great day and see you soon.